In this presentation, we will explore zeolites. Zeolites are hydrated framework tectosilicates of usually calcium, aluminium, and sometimes sodium and potassium. They are a group of similar looking minerals that form at shallow depths when the lava has reached below 200 degrees Celsius during its cooling. The name is derived from two Greek words, zein and lithos, which means boiling rock. The mineral has been given this name because of its relatively low melting point, due to which it appears to be boiling when heated from a blowpipe. These bubbles are water vapors lost due to heating, but zeolites can quickly dehydrate when exposed to a humid environment. Like all silicates, silicon remains bonded to four oxygen atoms in the tetrahedral site, and since it is a framework silicate, oxygen anions are shared between such sites. Like most other framework silicates, they sometimes have aluminium in the place of silicon, which results in charge imbalance. The resulting negative charge in the framework is balanced by the anions such as sodium and calcium, which lie in the open spaces of the framework. Also, water is always present in a zeolite and is accommodated in these spaces. The three-dimensional network has open cavities in the forms of channels and ridges, which are occupied by water and other non-framework cations. The channels are large enough to allow passage of guest ionic and molecular species. We will later see how this property of zeolites is used for our benefit. Also, each zeolite mineral or zeolite mineral series has a different framework, and many more zeolites are being synthesized in the laboratory. There are nearly 150 structure types found so far, and to effectively study these, zeolites have their own commission called the Structure Commission of the International Zeolite Association, which has taken over the duty to assign a three-letter code to all the different zeolites, and for example, they have given the code NAT to natrolite. As regards to physical properties, zeolites are soft minerals with a hardness ranging from 3.5 to 5.5 on the Mohs scale, which is least when compared to quartz, feldspar, and sulfathites. Similarly, they also have the least specific gravity in silicates ranging from 2 to 2.4. Let us also see some of the minerals of zeolite family. Anelsite or alunkine, although classified as a zeolite, is structurally more similar to felsothoids. It is found in basalt and other igneous rocks and also occurs in cavities of other zeolites. Natrolite is a fibrous zeolite which forms long prismatic crystals. Continuous repetition of Al2Si3O10-2 form chains parallel to the prism length, and cross-linking of these chains form channels parallel to these chains. The framework arrangement of zeolites, like natrolite, requires a fixed Si2Al ratio, but zeolites like clinoptilobite, phyllipsite, and heulandite have a random Si2Al ratio distribution. High silica zeolites like clinoptilobite have few aluminium cations in tetrahedral sites, and so have few non-framework cations available for exchange. Whereas low silica zeolites like phyllipsite have high ion exchange capacities, but since clinoptilobite is more abundant, more applications of zeolite involve that mineral. Crystals of heulandite and clinoptilobite are tabular with a perfect cleavage. The framework consists of sheets of tetrahedra with no openings large enough to allow the passage of ions or molecules, which causes these zeolites to be impermeable. The crystals of heulandite are often referred to as coffin shape. Some zeolites exhibit considerable variation in the framework composition. Chevazite, for example, can have Si2Al ratios ranging from 3.0 to 1.0, where 1 is the lower limit for the amount of Al in any framework, and beyond 3, the formation of AlOAl is energetically less stable. Stilbite is yet another zeolite, and its crystals form sheaves or bundles of dog bone shape. Finally, we have apophyllite, which forms perfect crystals of tetragonal system. Its name means to leaf apart in Greek, because its crystals tend to peel apart when heated. Coming to occurrences of zeolites, zeolites represent the final stages in the cooling down of magma. They form in water-saturated environments with temperature less than 250 degrees Celsius and at depths less than 10 km. This commonly occurs where volcanic material, lava or tuff, react with surface water or groundwater, or where plagioclase-bearing rocks undergo reaction with pore fluids. The most widespread and economically important occurrences of zeolite is in the sedimentary rocks. Their formation can take place in shallow lakes, deep seafloor, and also in marine basins. Zeolites also occur in metamorphosed rocks, and many zeolites occur in cavities in basaltic rocks. This type of zeolites are found in the Deccan Plateaus of India. There are many uses of zeolite which exploit the ion exchange capabilities of the mineral. Zeolites are used in soil conditioning, which increases fertilizer efficiency due to the zeolite's molecular sieve properties. Zeoponics is a new method of plant growth which uses artificial soil with zeolites as a major component. Selectivity of clinoptilobite for certain heavy metals is the principle for many water and waste treatment plants. Zeolites rapidly take up and release water and exchange sodium and calcium during the process, which makes them useful as drying agents and to soften hard water. Even the cesium-137 from contaminated waters after the Chernobyl accident was removed with the help of zeolites. And zeolites like philipsite and modernite can also separate gases, and in USA, jebusite is used to separate CO2 from methane gas in landfill sites, and natural ferrite is used to remove elemental sulfur from gas streams. Thank you.